I greet you all. Hello and jambo. I am Franklin Wanyama, Mr. OTZ President from Kenya, Africa. Being born HIV positive is not a wish that any parent would like for his or her child. I was born HIV positive and the journey on ARVs and acceptance was not easy on my side. I started going for my clinics in 206 at IDA facility together with my mom, but all along, I never knew what the medication were meant for, because all along my mom used to tell me the medication I was taking were meant to treat my chest, which was a sweet lie to keep me taking my medication well. I came to my senses when I was in class 5, when I got to hear much from the support groups I used to attend at IDA. The medication and especially the spiritual support I got from the EDAPs, CHWs, doctors, social workers, and staff kept me going, even though it was not that easy because my home turned to hell since my dad was HIV negative. In the family, my mom and I were the only ones living with HIV. I felt so bad seeing my parents exchanging words and even fighting. And the only thing I could hear was mom being abused for being HIV positive together with me as her son. EDAP was of much support to me in my primary school level since they kept encouraging me to keep on taking my medication and being strong. I could go to the facility and meet my fellow children during support groups who were taking medication like me. I joined secondary school and it became more tough on my side because it was boarding, and the greatest challenge was how to take my medication in the dormitory where we shared with the other fellow students. EDAP, through the social worker, facilitated for me when I was in Form 2 to join a nearby school, which I saw it was a nice idea since I wanted to study hard and be able to take my ARVs again. I managed to study through the challenges of stigma from family and friends, but I kept praying that one day I would complete my secondary level and be able to help my mom and our family since I was the firstborn. After my secondary school, life became hell on me since my mom decided to go back to our rural home for good and leaving me in Nairobi alone. I felt abandoned and I felt like I would stop taking my ARVs medication, but I thank EDAP for encouraging me as I kept going for my classes and trainings. Life became hell on me and I saw like the burden was too much. Taking my ARVs medication on a daily basis and at home, I'm needed to play my roles as the firstborn and losing my best friend who used to encourage me when going for support groups at IDA. I went into depression and I decided to end my life by taking poisons. I posted on my status and covered myself in my bed and locked the door. I thank God for the EDAP staff who saw the post, called, but I could not pick my phone. I'm told they came and alerted each other and broke the door. I can't explain what happened in between, but I found myself at Mama Lucy Hospital at 1 a.m. surrounded by Dr. Mtuko, Dr. Jasper, Theresia, and my fellow peer mentors and friends on the hospital bed. With the help of EDAP psychologist, I managed to overcome and the ongoing spiritual care, which keeps me going strong. Since then, I found myself going publicly on my HIV status and standing firm to give hope to my fellow adolescents and young adults living with HIV and the community at large who are living with HIV that there is hope. I have been on media and several social media and networks to advocate for prevention, staying on care, and also end of HIV discrimination and stigma. I want to take this chance to thank all EDAP staffs, CHWs, and my fellow adolescents on care at EDAP for the support they have given me to the person I have grown to be. EDAP has become my home far away from Busia, Kenya. We need to advocate much of people who are living HIV positive, like let's say me and adolescents on the facilities, to be part of the education, health education to among the youths. Let's say like a leader like me who is public on my status and I do talk about HIV, we can get more of youth at the facility level or outside the community whom we can support on peer-to-peer whereby it can be of a very much benefit. And also, I would just wish we continue empowering more youths who are living HIV positive so that they can give hope to the society. But for now, most of the stigma that is killing people is self-stigma. Most of the people have not accepted themselves. That's why at EDAP, the social workers, the counselors, the doctors are doing a very good job, at least to help people who test HIV positive, we young people who are living HIV positive, at least to accept ourselves and have hope that there is life. And I would encourage most of the NGOs or any organization, when they come on board, let them involve the youth in implementing their purpose in this country or the community they will be touching. Because let's say like, either for now, they involve us as youth, we are peer mentors. So at least it's much easier for most of the youths to open up. As I finish, I would like to say there is hope. Thank you so much for listening to me, and may God bless you all abundantly. Asanteni sana, karibu EDAP.